गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। तो वी वुड लाइक टू कंटिन्यू अवर क्लास रिगार्डिंग टू सेलेक्ट क्लास हियर। ऑलरेडी वी हैव सीन समथिंग इन सेलेक्शन। सो यस्टरडे वी हैव सीन समथिंग इन सेलेक्शन दैट इज between and look at this between and followed by in operator has seen. Now today like will be also taken percentile and underscore. I have already told you that this could be taken, like will be taken, two different kinds of things. And wait for a while, let me open here SQL. Okay, so you please note down these two commands. So these two commands are a bit important for you to perform. Command number one is so look at this, why I have give this particular commands here, select. So everything from EMP, if I would select something like this, data will be displayed in as many number of rows. Too many rows have been displayed here. So to set up this particular environment, we would like to use two different types of so commands here. First one is so set linesize, line size. So by default it has been 80. You must be set up to 150. So that number of characters which could be displayed with one particular line will be increased from 80 to 150. So second one is so look at this, the page size in the sense, so this is the heading of your page and this is the specific data of your page. So how many lines it could be displayed? 1, 2. So this is first row, second row, third row, fourth row, fifth row, sixth row, seventh row, eighth row. Only 9 rows are displayed. So that is why you'd like to specify. So second command, set PAGESIZE, page size. So by default it is 9 rows or 10 rows. You may be increased from 9 to 10 rows to some 25. Okay, so these two must be operated here. Then let us see what is the environment setup it could be. SET LINES is enough. SIZE could be, IZE may be typed by you, may not be typed, but there is no problem. So however, this is 150, line size will be 150. Set page size, so some 50. Okay, now you can execute the previous command. The previous command can be select everything from, so EMP. If you execute this particular command, look at this. Everything will be displayed in single row and the total data will be displayed in single page. Okay, only one time you have your so heading and the total entire data has been available in single page. Okay, so for that you need to use so these two different kinds of commands. Command number one is set line size. By default it is 80 characters. You have to increase from 80 to 150. Set page size, number of rows for each page will be 10. So you have to increase so right away from 10 to 25. If we increase 25 or 50, however, you could increase something like that. Everything will be displayed in single row. Okay, however, these are not important for us. Let me go ahead with like. Normally, if you go ahead with thinking something about employee name, you could see, so this is Smith, Allen, Ward, Jones, Martin, something like that. Sometimes people may ask you, I have forgotten his name, but first character is A, and I have forgotten the remaining characters. Please display the names which will be starts with A. So such kind of information will be given to you. Then what shall we have to do? So we are here. We do have Alan, the name which could be starts with A as Alan, first name, and Adams, second name. Okay. So two different types of names are there. He wants to display both names and he will choose, yes, Alan is the actual name or Adams is the actual name. wanted to perform such kind of operations, then so you may be go ahead and display something like this. So that is, so like will be always used to take, like will be always used to take the assistance of, so this percentile and underscore here. Percentile in the sense, for example, if you consider, so length of each and every name, here it is five characters, you could see so six characters, here it is four characters, and so on and so forth, okay? So length of each and every name cannot be the same. Length of the name cannot be the same. Different kinds of lengths are available here. So if you want to display, the first character must be one thing, whatever the character you could consider, and remaining everything will be gets displayed by you, then you have to use percentile. What does it mean? E name, like, so what does it mean? A, capital A, because data is in capital letters, capital A, percentile. If you operate something like this in the sense, so it would be starts with A, and the number of characters after A might be any number, probably two characters, 10 characters, 20 characters, 4 characters, something like that. Remaining thing will be, okay? So remaining number of letters will be, so those many. If you want to specify something like this, so percentile will be taken all characters. If you specify a constant character, so except that remaining length will be all, maybe 4 characters in length, maybe 10 characters in length, maybe some 100 characters in length, that doesn't matter, except A, starting will be A, and remaining character will be anything of any length. Look at this. So I need to have select everything from EMP. So entire data is required by me, entire column information required by me, but the name might be seems like this, where ename, the column ename, so will be equal to, if you put equal to, so A percentile, sorry, capital A percentile. If you put something like this, it could not be display single row even, because, so this is a pattern. This pattern could be matched, could not be matched by using equal sign, okay? If you have any pattern, something like this, these patterns must be, so equal with the existed column name by using like. If you put, instead of equal, if you go ahead and check out with the like, yes, you have the information. Look at this, Alan and Adams. First character must be A, and remaining thing be anything, whatever it may be. Whatever the A to Z characters, whatever the characters may be, and any number of characters it might be. So both will be possible here. Okay, likewise, you could operate here. So finally, let me go ahead and display something about Turner and Martin. Miller. Okay, you could see one more condition I'd like to specify here. So any number of characters will be displayed, not exactly 5, not exactly 4, not exactly 100, any number of characters will be displayed here. So here, total names will be very little enough here. So that is why you have, coincidentally, both are having 5 characters, okay? However, it could be display anything. So let us go ahead and display second character as A. He remembers that his name has a second character as A. Look at this, Bard, Martin, and one more thing, James, something like this. So Bard, Martin, and James, something like this. So Bard is 4 characters, Martin is 6 characters, and James will be 5 characters, something like this. Everything will be displayed, provided, so second character as A. So for that, what we are supposed to use, so here, look at this, underscore will be always identifies single character existence. So let us consider, first character must be anything, and the remaining second character must be capital A, and the remaining characters might be anything. So first character must be anything. So underscore will be represents any character, and it is existed as first character. So first character might be anything. Second will be capital A, and the remaining characters might be anything. Okay, if you want to specify something like this, then you will go ahead and so apply like this. So single character will be identifies only one character position. only one character position. Let me give you one more query to understand single case underscore after this time. Okay, look at this. So select everything from EMP where the condition will be where. So e name like first character might be anything, that is underscore. Second character is only capital A, and third character, a fourth character, and remaining number of characters might be anything. Okay, look at this particular query. You could see, so all second characters might be A here. You please observe this particular thing. All second characters might be A here. Okay, so first character might be anything, and remaining number of characters also anything here. What is the length and what is the number of characters? It doesn't matter for us. So percentile could be always identifies number of characters. First character, single existence of character will be one, and second character must be a constant. So number of remaining number of characters might be anything. If you want to specify something like this, underscore A percentile. Let me discuss one more thing here. I'd like to display the person who understand that the person's name might be having four characters. He doesn't remember what is that name. Okay, length of number of characters within that particular name will be four characters, but he doesn't remember his name. So he asked you display the people who are having exactly four characters in length. The people names who are having four characters in length. They may be asked something like this. Now, how could you display here in the sense? Select everything. So from EMP where e name like, so now, so no character is specified to you. So he just specify number of characters with his name will be four. So therefore, first character anything, second character anything, third character anything, fourth character anything. Four underscores could be specified here. First character anything, second character anything, third character anything, and fourth character. So length of this, how many number of characters are here within our name here in the sense? Exactly four characters. So therefore, you have to specify that and enter. Twice I have typed this particular from, so that is why we got error message. Look at this. Observe the number of characters in each name. So it is 444. Okay, so like this, underscore will be first character anything, second character anything, third character anything, fourth character anything, and so on and so forth. So each and every existence of this particular underscore will be identifies any number of character. Okay, so this is first position character, second position character, third position character, fourth position character. So in this way, you have to operate so percentile and underscore with the assistance of like will be always used to identify the patterns within the characters or within the variables. So like will be always identifies the patterns of character data. Okay, these patterns might be percentile or it is underscore. Percentile will be any number of characters. Any number of characters. Whereas underscore will be so single character with existed position. So if you specify in second position might be anything. If you specify in third position might be anything. If you specify first position might be anything, something like that. Okay, these are the two different types of things which are available with us. So in this way, you could specify, so like operator, okay? Like operator and percentile underscore could also be specified in this particular fashion. So like this, you could apply this. So where class could be taken, so SQL operators here. After these operators, I hope that you got the points what I have discussed so far. So after this, what exactly you are supposed to discuss here in the sense, let me go ahead with this one. So this is gets over. Okay, order by is pending here. Let me discuss about order by in this regard. So order by in the sense, it is going to display the contents of your entire data. So look at this, select everything from EMP okay, everything from EMP. So here you could see this data will be available here, and enames are not in specific order. Enames are not in specific order here. You can see, so first character, first one is Smith, followed by Allen, Ward, Jones. In miscellaneous order, the data has been displayed. If you want to display in a specific way, I mean, either it is in ascending order or it is in descending order, then you have to go ahead with so order by clause. Look at this, select, so everything from EMP. So what is the syntax of this particular order by? Order by attribute name or position, whatever the position you could consider, either in ascending order or in descending order. If you eliminate this ascending or descending from your query, by default it is taken ascending order. Okay, look at this. So EMP, so order by, so ename, if you specify something like this, by default it could be taken ASC, that is ascending order. If you're specifically speaking about the descending order, you need to specify DESC. So observe the difference between these two. First one is Smith, Allen, Ward, something like this here. Adams, Allen, Blake, Clark, Ford, and so on and so forth in terms of ascending order here. The same thing in terms of a descending order, yes, you could specify ename by DESC, descending order. If you specify descending order, look at this. So Ward, Turner, Smith, and so on and so forth. Okay, like this, it has been displayed here. In this way, order by could be took place here. If you are not aware of this particular column, where exactly it is existed, what is the name of this particular column, then you have to specify. I'd like to show you one example. So for this one, for position? For position, I'd like to show you one example here. So that example will be seems like this. Yesterday I have taken, so by applying some kind of expression on these values, then how it could be displayed. So select, so ename comma salary into, so 0.1% from EMP. If I would select something like this, look at this, the values will be in miscellaneous order, 80 160 125, and so on so forth. Many number of values are there, but it doesn't have any column name. It is having some expression. These kind of expressions cannot be taken by order by clause. Okay, it doesn't have any column name. No column name is here. Here it is expression. Then within this regard, how could you specify here is, so select employee name and salary into 0.1% from EMP, order by. So in which position it is being existed? This is the first column, first position column, this is second position column. So specify two. Okay, specify two. Look at this. 80, 95, 110, and so on and so forth. Okay, in this way, so position must be specified something like this. Otherwise, I wanted to put a particular column name here. Instead of this one, I would like to put a particular column name here. Then how could you put the column name? This column name also temporary column name. It doesn't store anywhere else. Already I have given some clear information to you in the previous class. So in selection, expressions cannot be stored anywhere else. Okay, they will be displayed for a while. Soon you have to complete the, so displaying that particular data. So the thing is not available with any database here. So I don't require this particular name. So salary into 0.1 is not required by me. Instead of this one, increment. Let me put a particular word, opted word, that is increment. Then how could you specify that? So look at this. Instead of this one, after specifying your entire expression, give one space and within double quotes. Already I told you double quotes cannot be used in SQL. Only one place double quotes could be used, that is this particular thing, column alias name will be the place where exactly double quotes will be used. This is the column alias name. The alias name is INCREMENT. Increment is my name from EMP, where, sorry, order by. Here you can use, for this particular session, you could use increment could be eligible. Okay, it is not taken here in 12. So in 8, 9, and 10Z, it is eligible. There is no problem at all. Here it is not accepting. I don't know why. So however, so look at this. Previously, it has been come as a salary into 0.1. Now it is increment. Okay. So in this way, you can specify the column alias. This is column alias. Actual name is this one. It is not supposed to be shown in a proper way because it is an expression. Expression cannot be the column name. So that is why you have to change the expression. Instead of this expression, you have to put another name as alias name. This is called as column alias. So in this way, you could operate order by class. And in this way, you will also include some column aliases. So interviewer might ask you one question that where exactly double quotes can be used in Oracle or SQL. So you have to give answer that in only one situation. That situation is by specifying the column alias names. Okay. So that is what about the information regarding to selection. I'll come back this particular selection after some other time. Okay. Now let me go ahead with insert. Okay. Wanted to insert some data into the table. How could you insert here? There are four different types of ways which we have to insert the data here. So number one, this is the actual syntax of insertion. So kind of insertion is a single row insertion. Okay. Second one is single row insertion with input. You have to take some input and insert a single row. And third one is single row insertion for selected columns. You may not require to enter all columns information at this moment. You have some amount of data with you. So if you want to insert only available number of columns data, yes, you could go ahead and insert them. Otherwise, so it could not. And one more thing is single row insertion for selected columns with input. So here you maybe accept some kind of input at this place. Here input could not be taken into consideration. So here also same. Input will be taken. Input could not be taken into consideration. Okay. So now you could see. You could see how this could be happened here. So let me take this particular thing here. Select everything from TAB. Let me look at what are the tables we have. Yes, we have employee table is there with us. Let me describe EMPLOYEE, employee. Yes, employee ID, employee name, designation, ESL, and let me reduce this one left side. So that's 100. Okay. Sorry, describe. Describe. So EMPLOYEE. Okay, look at this. Employee ID, so number, employee name, character, designation, so again character, then salary, number, department number, varchar2. Okay, department is varchar2. How you could insert? For the first, this is actual syntax. So this syntax will be divided into four types. Okay, this syntax has been divided into four types. So single row insertion. Single row insertion in the sense, insert, look at this, the syntax. Insert into table name. So within square brackets, attribute one and so on, attribute n, followed by values. So ampersand value or expression, ampersand value or expression and so on. Finally, subquery also be taken here. Okay, let me introduce a single row insertion at a time. So look at this, insert into table name is employee, okay, values. The values, first one is employee ID, that is 100. Second one is employee name. So when varchar2 or, let me explain to you by taking this one. When varchar2 or character, if you have this kind of data type, you must include single quotes. Single quotes, whatever the data you are expected to enter, that must be taken into consideration. Whereas, if you have a date data type with you, you must enter the data so in the form of so DD-MON-YYY, so within single, enclosed within single quotes. So if date data type will be there, it could be entered like this. If character data type will be there, of course, you have to enclose within single quotes, whatever the data you are required, you have to enter it. Okay, look at this, how it could be done here. So varchar2, e-name is varchar2, single quotes. So that is, the name is Hari, okay, capital letters, Hari. Hari, followed by designation is, so assistant, PRO, assistant professor, comma, salary is so 12,000 rupees, 12,000 rupees, and department is CSE. Let us consider CSE. One row has created, completely one row has created. Look at this, select everything from EMP, sorry, employee, EMPLOYEE, employee. Okay, look at this. Completely one row is introduced. So here, what exactly you did here, every data which you are trying to enter, that must be typed by you. This command will be typed by you continuously for several times. So if you want to introduce one more row, so insert into table name is EMPLOY, employee values. Again, you have to type this one, and 101, some Raja, some name. So assistant professor, comma, some 12,000 rupees is salary, comma, so CSE. Continuously you have to type something like this. It may be create some kind of bore while you have to enter the data into this particular table. So that is why I hope that you understand how to introduce single row data. So single row in the sense continuously complete columns must be required to enter data here. That is what the meaning. Okay, that is what the meaning here. So instead of doing this one, so you may be enter single row insertion with input. What does it mean? It must be prepared something like this. Insert into employee values. So here, don't enter actual data. You have to enter, already observe the syntax here, ampersand value, and so on. Instead of value, you have to specify ampersand name. So if it is integers, so directly you have to specify ampersand EID, employee ID, comma. Then second one is varchar2. Since it is varchar2, you have to enclose within single quotes, as a specified single quotes. So ampersand E name, okay, comma. Then third one is designation. So ampersand, within single quotes, ampersand, so EDESIG, whatever the column name you have with you, so type that particular column name here, comma. So next one is number, so that without this single quotes, you have to type it. So what is that? ESAL, salary. Last one is, again, it is character, so ampersand EDEPT, okay? So take this one and enter this value. Now, it may ask you some So input here, enter value for whatever the character you have typed, whatever this word you have typed here, that particular word will be displayed here. Now you may be enter 102, then followed by enter e name. Whatever the word you have given here, that name will be, that word will be displayed here. Okay, ampersand is causes, enter value for. So followed by whatever the word you have, that word will be displayed here. So that is, so some name, designation, assistant professor, and then salary 15,000, and then department CSE. Now if you are entering some data at this particular place, no need to give any single quotes. Already we have specified single quotes here, so that you no need to specify single quotes here, no problem. Now you can see, okay, one row has created. Wanted to enter one more row, then you have to take this one, because if you open edit, if you open buffer, the buffer has the most recent command here. So since this is the most recent command, how many number of rows you are entered. So by applying slash, you have to take it. So 103, some name, some 15,000 or designation is assistant professor. So 15,000 is salary and CSE is. Wanted to insert one more? Yes, you could take one more input. Okay, 104, some name, and then assistant professor, and then 15,000 as salary, and again CSE department. Okay, like this, you can take, so like this, and so on and so forth, you have to enter the data. So look at this, select everything, so from employee. Look at this. These are the specific data what we have entered so far. Okay. So now if you open your buffer, most recent comment is select everything for employee. So that could be there here. So you could not execute insert into, because this command, this insert into command has been overwritten by select star from EMP. So whatever the most recent command what we have typed here, that could be taken into consideration by so the buffer here. So if you want to execute, so you just copy this particular command again. You just copy this particular command. So the copied command will be pasted here, and then execute this one for a while. So 10105, some name, assistant professor, then followed by 15,000 as salary, CSE department. Now, if you open edit, yes, your most recent command is this one. Therefore, yes, you have applied this one, and go ahead. Some name. Oh, sorry. Okay. Look at this. The name will be employee ID will be 106. British. And the designation is assistant professor, and salary is 15,000, followed by CSE. Look at this. Okay, in this way you can enter the data. Now you please observe, if you select the data, select everything from EMP, employee. Look at this, assistant professor is common for everybody. 15,000 is common for everybody. CSE is common for everybody. If you look such kind of data, some common kind of data will be available with you. Here, you can use the default operation. While it is being created, you have to use default. Okay? Default expression can be used here. I have already created this particular table. If you go ahead and describe EMPLOYE, employee, so already created. Now let me add some default values here for designation and department. Let me add default values here. So for doing that default, adding default things, so alter table name is employee, okay? My column name is EDESIG, so VRCHR2 of varchar2 of some 20. Now I have to add default, DEFAULT. Default, what I am supposed to take here? ASSTPROF, okay? Assistant professor. Here I have missed one thing, modify. The class has been missed here. Modify has been missed. Okay, your table has been altered. Alter table must be taken, either it is add, modify, or drop, something like this. One class must be taken here. So that is why the class has been missed here. So that is why the problem will be arising here. So table has been altered here. If I omit to introduce the data for this particular designation at this moment, by default it has been come with. So assistant professor, ASST.PROF, okay? One more thing I'd like to specify here, modify, last one is EDEPT, employee department, here it is varchar2 of 20, and the default value is CSE. Let me take CSE. If I would apply this one, it's also be modified. Now let me go ahead and execute the third one. If I would take this particular thing, so how it could be taken into consideration? I don't require to enter the data for employee designation and employee department. Don't require these two because all are assistant professor and all department is CSC. So that is why insert into table name is EMPLOYE. Employee, here you have to specify the what you call column names. So EID, I would like to enter data for EID. E-name also entered. So it's, I'm interested to enter this one also. ESCIL, these two also. So interested to enter. Values. Now you can see EID is, let me look into 107. So name is some name. And the salary is 15,000. Okay, if I would take something like this, row has been created. Now you can see, select everything from employee. I have here, as per the value which have been entered for this table, I have omitted to enter designation. I'm also omitted to enter department. These two has been omitted here. Even then, you could see. So for 107 Uday, assistant professor is there and the CLC also be there. If you are omit to enter the data, default values will be taken into consideration. So that is why default values are used in this particular scenario. Okay. If any columns might be required default values, then you will go ahead and evaluate that. Okay. In this way, you can enter the default values. And in this way, you can enter the data insert the data into a particular table. Okay, I will discuss this one by tomorrow. You please remember, so this data, 107, so 8 rows of data has been entered by me. So remember, tomorrow, whether these 8 rows of data will be there or not, we will see.